Welcome to our 26th annual Flag Day celebration. I'm Leanne Taylor from Seroptimus International Federal Way, and I'm proud to see what a beautiful crowd, what a wonderful, wonderful crowd. I'd like to briefly mention just a couple of great milestones that are happening in Federal Way. We'd like to celebrate our 25th year as being a city. Also, Seroptimus will be celebrating their 40th year this year. So would all of my Seroptimus members please stand? Thank you to the Seroptimus members, the staff of Pete, for putting this wonderful celebration together. So it is my pleasure actually, to introduce King County Council member Pete von Reichbauer. He's the chair of the Regional Policy Committee of King County Council, as well as the chair of the Government Accountability and Oversight Committee. Pete has served 2 years as chair of King County Council, 6 years as a vice chair, and unprecedented 3 years as the chair of the Budget and Financial Management Committee. Prior to his election to King County Council, Pete served as a member of the Washington State Senate. In 2015, Pete von Reichbauer was named Public Official of the Year at the 56th Annual Seattle Municipal League Foundation. Pete has served on founding boards of trustees of St. Francis Community Hospital, the Federal Way Boys and Girls Club, Vice Chair of the United States Olympic Commission Committee of Washington, and the Federal Way's Kiwanis as a past president. So please help me by a round of applause for King County Council member Pete von Reichbauer.
Thank you, Leanne. And also a special thank you to Todd Beamer High School Jazz for their opening selections. Please give them a round of applause. Please rise for the presentation of colors presented by the South King County Fire Department Honor Guard. This time we'd like to bring forward and recognize the number of guests here, the Mayor of Federal Way, Mayor Jim Farrell.
Thank you, Pete. Welcome to Federal Way, where it's always sunny and 75. It's my honor to be here as your mayor, and I just want to let you know that I think Flag Day is a great event in which we can talk about the symbology, the symbolism of our flag and what it means and how it symbolizes our union. But this is also a great time to talk about what it represents, the ideals that America and that union represents. I want to let you know that just 24 hours ago, one day ago, almost exactly at this time, I stood before that giant flag that is mentioned and was the inspiration for the Star-Spangled Banner. That Star-Spangled Banner hangs in Washington, D.C., and I stood before it. And it really was an awe-inspiring vision. It's 30 feet by 34 feet. And it's such a tremendous story, and I won't belabor the issue here, but what was really at issue, if you will recall, that just 21 days, 3 weeks before that battle, before the Battle of Fort McHenry, the White House Washington had been overrun, the White House had been burned to the ground, and the British had advanced up to Baltimore. The Battle of Fort McHenry was a desperate, desperate struggle, and that bombardment went on for 25 hours. Incomprehensible. And then at the very next morning, 3 weeks after the White House had been burned down, essentially, Francis Scott Key, as a prisoner aboard an English vessel, saw that flag that was still there. That flag stands still today, and it stands proud, and it is a representative of what our country is all about. So I think, well, I'm sure what Francis Scott Key wrote and what he would mean even today is that we are the land of the free and the home of the brave. So on behalf of the 92,000 souls who call Federal Way home, I just want to say welcome and happy Flag Day. Thank you.
At this time, we've been blessed by so many people participating here today, the BFW, the Lions Club, and the Seroptimus, who have made this whole program so successful. Today we're going to have another round of music at this time by the Harmony Kings Town Squires. If they can join us, please.
You all know America the Beautiful and God Bless America, so join us as we sing.
Aquatic Center has been our masterpiece and location here for this event for many, many years. This center has been the attraction that has brought many great participants. Michael Phelps swam in this pool. Quite frankly, one night in her clothes, Linda Kochmar fell in the pool, and she swam in that pool as well. But we have had a lot of great events at this pool. And to talk about future events is our pool coordinator, Mike Dunwoody. Mike?
Our council member swam as well. He played after plummeting 10 meters through the air into the dive tank. Hey, I just, real briefly, we have events every weekend, but we have one in particular. If today's events, you don't feel like you have enough patriotism to carry you through the winter, this December, the first week of December, we're having our country's premier swimming event. It's the AT&T Winter Championships, and it'll be nationally televised. So if you don't get here, you can at least watch it on TV and feel proud of your community. And it's very exciting because, as you know, next year is the 2016 Olympics in Rio. So our swimmers will be swimming very fast, and they'll be doing their best performances to try to either make the team or to increase their standings in the world. So please mark your calendars for that. And just one other brief thing. We're celebrating our 25th anniversary, just like the city. And I think the city's doing their celebration pretty quick here, next week. And we're doing ours in the fall, so kind of watch out. And probably September, October, around there, we'll have a special event. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Mike. Mike was kind enough not to mention that before I jumped off the 10-meter board, I had three glasses of wine. I jumped with the superintendent of schools, by the way, at the same time. This time, to welcome us to the great city of Federal Way is Becca Martin. She's the president and CEO of the Federal Way Chamber of Commerce. Becca?
Thank you very much, sir. I don't know what kind of parties you guys are at, but I think we'd all like to go, don't you think? So it's a great day in Federal Way, and what a morning. And on behalf of the business community of Federal Way, let me share with you what a privilege it is today to join you on Flag Day. I see we're all decked out in our red, white, and blue. Some of us are in uniforms that are black and green and blue and white. But what makes them special are not the colors that we're wearing, but the colors of our flag. The red, white, and blue that is the flag we celebrate today. The uniforms work to make sure that those colors are flying freely as the flag of our great nation, a country whose very colors mean freedom throughout the world. The flag is not just a symbol of America. It's a way of life, and it certainly is our way of life in Federal Way as we celebrate and honor our veterans. We honor our flag because it honors the ideals of our citizenry. It stands ever ready to remind us not only of those who work even today to secure our liberty, but those who work like our elected officials throughout the year to fulfill the civic responsibility to participate in the great democracy that is the United States of America. So if I could take a moment, could we please have a round of applause for all the elected officials, whether or not the mayor made it to his list, for what they do every day. And let's be clear, they are only able to do that because of the veterans who secured that liberty for all of us. So veterans, one more time for them. So as we commemorate our flag, let us also remember those who served to protect us in the past and those who cannot be with us today, because they are fulfilling that same legacy that our veterans have. No matter what the color of their uniform, their hearts are beating true throughout our history. And today we honor all of those lives as we celebrate the red, the white, and the blue. Thank you.
Today we have a very special pleasure and a very special guest. General Nam-pyu Park is a Korean veteran. He is a true example of bravery and what it really means to serve one's country and put others before yourself. His lifetime accomplishments embody everything we are celebrating today. That is why I'm honored to present to General Park this recognition from the King County Council. General Park. In 1961, General Park commanded the 21st Infantry Division as a Major General and went on to receive his MBA from the university. He received retired from the Republic of Korea Army and won medals from the United States as well, and was recognized by President Dwight David Eisenhower. General Park, you are a hero in your country, and you've chosen to live in our country, and we're very honored to have you here, sir. General Park, please rise.
Today, he interpreted to Yi Jung-sung. Oh, here. Yeah. I'm not Korean. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. 여러분 안녕하십니까? 박남표입니다. 오늘 같이 또 깊은 행사에서 여러분께 시계 서게 된 것을 모하니 영광스럽게 생각합니다.
Good morning, distinguished guests and honorable veterans. My name is Nam-pyu Park. It is with great pleasure that I speak before you today on this meaningful occasion.
먼저 국가 충성하고 자유의 평화와 수호를 하기 위해서 봉사하신 현역 예비역 전역 군인 경찰관들을 초청하여 그 공로를 그리고 오거라 제26회 블랙데이 행사를 개최한 메트로폴리탄 킹 카운티 비반 라이트 바워의 위원장님 비롯한 모든 관계자들에게 감사를 드립니다.
First of all, I'd like to express my deepest gratitude toward the King County Council member Pip and Rye Bauer and the Federal Reserve Board for hosting this special Flag Day celebration in recognition of active duty reservists and retired military personnel as well as police officers.
오늘 이 노장에게 주신 명예로운 큰 장은 이 자리에서 참석하신 한국전 참전용사님들과 함께 수상의 영광을 나누고 싶습니다. 그리고 유해군으로서 소속되어서 멀고 먼 나라, 낯선 나라에서 목숨을 걸고 용감히 싸워주신 여러분들의 희생을 공로를 한국은 자유롭게 평화로운 굳건히 지킬 수 있도록 민주주의를 단란하게 꽃피워줄 수 있음을 우리는 결코 잊지 않고 있습니다.
As a long-time retiree from military service, I deeply honored and humbled to be the recipient of this special recognition today. I want to share this honor with all the Korean War veterans who fought under the UN banner in what was once a little-known country in the Far East. Your courageous service and sacrifice during the war will never be forgotten by us. Thanks to the critical support of our American allies, South Koreans were able to defend our people's freedom and peace and go on to build one of the world's preeminent democracies.
65년 전 자유 수호를 위해서 함께 싸워주시고 한국전이 종식된 후에도 대한민국의 든든한 제1의 후방국으로서 전장 후에 피해 복구 지원은 물론 군사적 경제적 지원을 아끼지 않을 미국이 어떻게 1950년 당시에는 세계에서 가장 빈곤하던 우리 국가가 오늘날 1인당 GNP 3만 3천 불을 넘게 경제 대국으로서 성장하게 된 것을 참 우리는 크게 이루어진 것을 감사하게 생각합니다.
In the years since the armistice of 1953, the United States has remained a faithful friend to South Korea. The U.S. provided crucial military and economic support that facilitates Korea's recovery from the damages of war. The Republic of Korea in 1950 was one of the poorest countries in the world. Today, it boasts a gross national income per capita of over $33,000. This remarkable transformation could only have been possible because of the war veterans who were there 65 years ago fighting in the name of freedom.
또한 한국과 미국 양국 간의 굳건한 우호 관계를 바탕으로 하다 이곳에 동포 사회가 그간 눈부신 성장을 이룰 수 있도록 있었다고 믿고 있습니다. 미주류 사회와 동포 사회가 밀집이 교류하며 지역 사회에서 동포 사회에 이르기까지 뜨거운 감회를 느끼게 됩니다. 이 모두가 이곳에 계신 여러분들의 노력과 결실이 생기라고 생각되며 참 진심으로 감사합니다.
I believe that Puget Sound's thriving Korean American community owes much to the close relationship between the U.S. and the South Korea. As a longtime resident of this region, I'd like to express my gratitude to our community leaders for their collaborative efforts to bring about remarkable developments in this region.
끝으로 부탁의 말씀이 있습니다. 한미 양국 간의 부호 증진의 증표로서 킹 카운티 수영장 바로 옆 페더웨이 시 부지에서 한미 우호 공원을 조성하는 사업이 추진하고 있는데 본인이 미국 존 햄플 장군과 함께 땅 명예 추진위원장으로서 중책을 맡고 있습니다. 한미 우호 공원이 성공적으로서 건립됨으로 인해서 한미 양국 간에 있어서 우주미 더욱 빛나고 영원히 기억할 수 있도록 여기에 계신 여러분들께서 값진 사업에 적극적인 관심과 지원을 동참하여 주시면 더욱 감사하겠습니다. 대단히 감사합니다.
As a testament to the strong friendship between the United States and the Republic of Korea, members of our community are building the U.S.-Korea Amity Park in the city of Federal Way, just within short walking distance of the King County Aquatic Center. General John Hemphill and I are co-honorary chairs for this project, and I asked all of you for your undivided support of this project so that we can commemorate these two countries' enduring friendship in a beautiful and lasting memorial. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
The military understands that the person who wears a uniform serves in the military, but also those who serve at home. Please recognize Mrs. Park, the General Park. As you can recognize, this has been a very strongly focused day on the Pacific. You know, historically, when I grew up, we talked about the special relationship between Great Britain and the United States. It began with Winston Churchill and Franklin Roosevelt and continues today with President Obama and Prime Minister Cameron. But the next generation is the generation of the Pacific Ocean. And the special relationship that we have with Great Britain is today matched by the special relationship we have with the Republic of Korea. We are friends in war, we are friends in peace. We are great traders among ourselves, and we work together culturally. And we in Federal Way and South King County are blessed with the strong Korean population that has made our region the stronger and the better for their infusion of good ideas, good company, and quite frankly, have raised the educational level of our community. And today, we're very pleased by the Consul General being here today to present a Medal of Peace to two individuals in our community. One he's already physically presented, but he's going to be acknowledged again, which is Al Dembowski, and then to Mr. Honda, who's going to be represented by his son, I believe. And so without further ado, I'd like to invite General Moon up here to the podium, our Consul General from the Republic of Korea, Consul General Moon.
Good morning, everybody. I cannot find any level of good words to express our thankfulness to our Korean War veterans. Especially taking this opportunity, I am very honored to bestow one book to Mr. Dembowski, who had already obtained our medal for peace. Another, our medal will be given to the son-in-law of Honorable Harris Honda. I'm very happy to do this. Thank you.
This time, Al Dembowski, who served in the war. Al, can you share a little bit about your briefly about your experience in the Korean War?
Like a lot of other people, I served in the Army in Korea, winter and summer. And I'm honored to be here, and thank you for being here and your presence, what it represents, and your willingness to do something more to the flag and all that it represents. Thank you.
Thank you. And to recognize the Honda family, Bruce Honda is going to be here to receive the Peace Medal from the Consul General. Oh, wow. Thank you very much. Bruce, can you share a little bit about your father's experience? Anything to share with you?
Well, my father was in the United States Navy, and he served aboard the USS Dashiell. Destroyer that supported ground and air troops. He was a sonarman and also a torpedo man on the destroyer.
Thank you for your service.
Lately in the news, we have seen incidents with police officers that have been in the news, but we'd like to recognize police officers who have dedicated their lives in making our community a better place in which to live. I'd like to bring up to the front, recognizing that many officers today not only serve their communities in uniform, but also serve our country in uniform. Officer Terry Carter from the Algona Police Department. Terry here. Thank you. Officer James McKay, Algona Police Department. James. Lieutenant Brigham Schultz, Federal Way Police Department. Lieutenant Schultz. And Officer Jeff Mundell of the Federal Way Police Department. Please join me in thanking them again.
Coming here and giving us the opportunity to have this recognition. It was an honor to be selected to be here. And we look forward to it.
Thank you very much. Thank you, officers. It's our way of recognizing you because, again, I think we forget that many of these officers serve not only on the weekdays, but serve on the weekends, providing a great deal of service to us. So now we have an opportunity to bring forth a friend of mine of long standing. He is retired from the Army as a Brigadier General after completing 32 years of active and reserve service. He received the Distinguished Service Medal. He has served his community in Lakewood, where I grew up, and now he serves as a council member for Pierce County. He is an individual that has really put himself not just involved in the community, but committed to his community. As someone who grew up in South Pierce County, growing up, Lakewood has been a part of my life in the growing up period. And Doug has committed himself and his family to making Lakewood and the greater Pierce County area a much better place. He brings the lessons he learns from the military to his application in elective office. So without further ado, I'd like to introduce Brigadier General Doug Richardson.
Thank you very much. Thanks for having me in the King County. And my remarks that I have written here, I was going to start out by recognizing people in the audience. And having seen how well that went earlier, I'm not going to do it, but welcome to all of you who are here. You know, a little later this morning, and I should point out, I really appreciated Councilmember Von Reichbauer's words about the relationship with the Korean community in Federal Way. We also have that very strong relationship in the Lakewood area as well. And I should point out the general, the co-chair for the park that's going to be established here in Federal Way, Major General John Hemphill, who is an amazing individual, is also a constituent of mine, and also was awarded the Distinguished Service Cross in the Korean War. Well, a little later this morning, I'm going to have the opportunity to swear or give the oath of enlistment to some individuals to join the United States Army and serve this nation. In a very short enlistment oath, they will swear to support and defend the Constitution of the United States, and they'll bear their allegiance. So in a very, very few words, what that in essence means is that they will commit to serving the citizens of the United States of America. And you know, it's truly fitting that these soldiers take this oath today, because as we celebrate Flag Day, June 14th, June 14th is also the day that is the Army's birthday. Established in 1775, the Army's 240th birthday is tomorrow. So why don't we all wish the Army a happy birthday this morning? Now, the bad thing about being late in the program is you have to listen to other speakers cover most of your remarks. Done very well by the Beamer JROTC contingent, who talked about the fact that the date for Flag Day goes to June 14th, 1777, when the Betsy Ross design flag was adopted as the flag for the 13 United States by the Continental Congress. And as she pointed out, there have been 27 versions of that flag since 1777. And those changes were made as states joined the Union. And of course, the last change was on July 4th, 1960, when Hawaii became our 50th state. So, Flag Day. Not a national holiday. In between Memorial Day and the 4th of July, which are holidays. But Flag Day, you should know, came into being like so many other things in this great nation. It came into being because a citizen desired that the flag be recognized and worked tirelessly for that recognition of the flag. Eventually, he convinced the local school board to host a patriotic program in the local schools where children had little flags and people gave speeches and they sang patriotic songs, much like we did this morning. And I really love the patriotic songs. I was raised as a kid singing those, and I certainly hope that school districts throughout this country are still singing those songs so as children can commit them to memory. But the observance of Flag Day spread. In fact, it even became a holiday in Montour County in Pennsylvania. And eventually, governors were holding Flag Days in their states. And so in 1916, President Woodrow Wilson signed a proclamation recognizing the 14th day of June as Flag Day. And in the United States, we continued to honor that proclamation until 1949. And in 1949, President Harry Truman signed legislation making the 14th day of June officially Flag Day in the United States. In 1966, the Congress passed legislation that requested that the President issue annually a proclamation designating the week in which June 14th falls as National Flag Week. So, how do we honor the flag? There's a booklet that's available to you this morning that covers all the ways you're supposed to display the flag and the courtesies and the protocols which you're supposed to follow, such as proudly flying your flag on national holidays, offering the proper courtesies to our colors when they pass by, standing up when it passes by, stand up during the playing of the national anthem, and place your hand over your heart when reciting the Pledge of Allegiance. And it's good to follow customs. But it seems to me that beyond customs, we should acknowledge, as Pastor said earlier, that we live in the greatest country on earth and have received great blessings as a people. In 1918, there was a contest held in the United States for someone to write an essay that could become the national creed. And Mr. Page won that essay contest, and it was penned and it was named the American's Creed. And I don't know if you've heard it lately, but I'm going to recite it this morning because it seems to me it does cover how we should honor our flag. as I read this creed, listen for the passages and phrases from great documents in our history, from the Declaration of Independence, the preamble to the Constitution, which I had an opportunity to write several times in eighth grade detention. They don't call it detention any longer. I'm not sure what the name of it is. The Lincoln's Gettysburg Address and Daniel Webster's reply to Robert Y. Hayne in the United States Senate in 1830. I believe in the United States of America as a government of the people, by the people, for the people, whose just powers are derived from the consent of the governed, a democracy and a republic, a sovereign nation of many sovereign states, a perfect union, one and inseparable, established upon those principles of freedom, equality, justice, and humanity for which American patriots sacrificed their lives and fortunes. I therefore believe it is my duty to my country to love it, to support its constitution, to obey its laws, to respect its flag, and defend it against all enemies. That, ladies and gentlemen, is how I think we should honor the flag and this nation. Thank you very much. God bless you. God bless the United States of America.
Thank you, Doug. And again, thank you for your service to our country, and thank you for your continued service to your own community. A special part of our program is the recognition of the service that many of us had the privilege of doing. We're going to have the Todd Beamer High School Jazz Band perform the Armed Forces Medley. And when the song of the service that you served in, or maybe you're a parent or you have a child who served in, and I see my friend Mrs. Selsky back there. Sue Selsky has the privilege of not only being married to a veteran, but having a son now overseas serving, David serving. And thank you, Sue, for all you do and all you have done. Sue Selsky, please. At this time, I'd like to recognize the Todd Beamer High School, and they're going to play medleys of the various armed forces. And when you hear the one that you feel most appropriate, please rise for it and serve and stand with it, just as you stand with our flag. Todd Beamer. Thank you.
Todd Beamer. Awesome. We're very fortunate to have a school like Todd Beamer in our backyard here. One of the great opportunities that this program provides us, and General Richardson referenced it earlier, is the opportunity to witness a special time for young men and women who will stand before you. U.S. Army Staff Sergeant Workman, please present your recruits at this time. Why don't you folks come on up here? I'd also like to invite Casey Treat, Reverend Casey Treat, who has been such an incredible presence in our community. Casey, can you come forward? And before we begin the actual swearing-in, can you give a blessing at this time for this recruit?
Thank you, folks, for being here today. Thank you, recruits. Thank you to all of our service personnel. Let's pray. Father, we pray for our men and women who serve, who give, who sacrifice. We pray for these new recruits today. We ask for your hand upon them, your protection, your provision, your guidance. God, we thank you for America. We thank you for our services. We thank you for all that you've blessed us with. And we give you all the praise, and all the glory, and all the honor. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Thank you, Casey. This time I'd like to have General Richardson come forward and begin the administering the oath of service to these young men and women. General?
According to regulations, and uniform color military justice. So help me God.
Congratulations. Awesome. Thank you, General, and thank you, recruits, for continuing to serve our country. This time, the town squires are going to present a very special God Bless America, and please feel free to join in. And God Bless the USA as well.
Right down to Houston and New York. right to me, and I gladly stand up with you and defend her still today. There ain't no doubt I love this land, love this land. God bless USA. God bless the USA. God bless the USA.
Yeah. Thank you very much. I understand there's been a drawing and
the numbers for the raffle, 601-3496. 496 are the last numbers.
496. Raise your hand, 496.
Nope. You know, I have someone's raffle tickets.
Let's try another one here.
Okay. 489.
489. 489.
Oh wow. Must have been my speech.
692.
692. No, Bob Rigner, that's not yours. We do have a winner. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
First of all, I want to thank the Soroptimus, and I want to thank Bob Derrigan and the Lions Club with their wonderful hot dogs over here. But most of all, I want to thank those of you who have served our country. We couldn't enjoy today if others had not served before us. Thank you all. God bless.